The first thing you'll notice about the new VoiceThread is the way that the media has more room to grow. In fact, the media will now automatically fill the available space in the web browser no matter what size screen someone is on. The higher quality media display, higher resolution annotations, and a new zoom control enable conversations about the more fine-grained details of the media that you upload. From x-rays and architectural blueprints to spreadsheets and photographs, more detail should enable richer and more accurate conversations. Another big change is the design of the conversation channel, which is now on one side of the media only, and it scrolls indefinitely. So there's no pagination of comments. They're all right here in one column. Each comment also now has its own avatar image, so it's easier to find a specific comment from someone who has commented multiple times. And reordering comments is now easier than ever. Basically, you just click and drag a comment to a new location in the conversation timeline, and you drop it there. That's all there is to it. And it's not just comments. You can now reorder slides as well from right within the VoiceThread. Just open up the postcard view by clicking down here, and you can see all of the slides at the same time. Then just click and drag any of the slides to a new location, and that's it. The change is saved automatically. Now, this may look really boring visually, but there are certain types of people who are just crazy about keyboard commands, and let me show you why. Not only do keyboard commands provide good accessibility, they let you move around and use VoiceThread without touching your mouse at all. Once you start even using just a couple of them, you'll find it addictively fast and easy. One of the most requested feature updates has been for better support of long text comments. And so now the text comments scroll indefinitely, and you can even resize the comment window and undock it to drag it to a better location on your screen. All the same commenting options are still there, and they work in much the same way they always have. And so it shouldn't be difficult for anyone to make a transition to the new VoiceThread. But let's move out of a single VoiceThread and take a look at all the changes to how you manage, share, and create VoiceThreads, all of which will be much simpler now. First, your My Voice page is simply VT Home, and you can view all of your VoiceThreads in thumbnail view or list view. The sidebar now opens and closes, but it functions in much the same way as it did before, with a list of groups and search filters above them. One of the most requested management features has been bulk actions, and so now you can select a group of VoiceThreads and then share them all at once, either by clicking the share button or just dragging them onto the name of a group in your sidebar and then selecting what you want that group to be able to do. That's it. Another thing that's new is that when you click on the name of a group on the left, you'll see that you can select a header image for that group space to help set the appropriate tone for your group or class. You can also now grab a direct link to this view to share with members of your group or class, and that link will land them directly right here in this group view. One more new customization is that you can now select whether you want to work within a dark or a light environment, and you set that by clicking on your email in the upper right-hand corner and then selecting Display Preferences and then clicking on that preference. And that's it. The change is made instantly. Next, let's take a look at creating a VoiceThread, which you do by clicking Add Media and selecting one of the options, or just dragging and dropping files onto your web browser. The files will then upload and process, and when they're done, you'll see the new slides, and you can edit them, delete them, or reorder them just by dragging them to a new location. All of your playback options can still be accessed here on the right, but now let's open this thread up and make some comments before we share it. Again, all of the same commenting controls are right there, so you'd make all the commentary you want, and then when you're done, you just close it and move on to share. This new sharing dialog is much more powerful than the old one, but it's also simpler too. Whether you're sharing with a group, a person in that group, or a contact, the workflow is exactly the same. Just find them and select them, which adds them to this area on the right, and then you choose what you want them to be able to do, and then you click share, and that's it. One really nice new feature for power users will be the new Who Has Access tab, which allows you to see at a glance a list of everybody who already has access and what they can do, and you can even edit that list from right here. Overall, this new sharing dialog is more advanced than the previous one, but it's also simpler to use and learn, which is something we think that characterizes everything about the new VoiceThread.